Namaste and welcome to Deepak's Creative World. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe to get notifications on my new videos. So, let's begin. In this episode of World's Amazing Locations, I'm going to talk about Ellora Caves and the mysteries of Kailasa Temple. A UNESCO World Heritage Site located in the Aurangabad district of Maharashtra in India, Ellora Caves are one of the largest rock-cut monastery temple caves in the world. These caves are believed to be built during 600 to 1000 CE. The caves are located 30 km away from Aurangabad and 80 km away from Ajanta Caves. Ellora Caves served as lodgings to the traveling Buddhist and Jain monks. The caves consist of 17 Hindu caves, 12 Buddhist and 5 Jain caves with monasteries which depict the mythology of each religion. There are over 100 caves at Ellora, but only 34 of them are open to the public. Just like Ajanta, Ellora Caves are one of the most incredible works of art from ancient India. The highlight of Ellora is the Kailasa Temple in cave number 16. It is a particularly notable cave temple in India as a result of its size, architecture, and having been entirely carved out of a single rock. The Kailasa Temple is inspired by Mount Kailash and is dedicated to Lord Shiva. Many people who have researched the temple believe that it was excavated vertically. The builders started at the top and worked downward, carving out one of the captivating ancient temple complexes on earth. According to a legend told by the people of Maharashtra, a queen whose husband was very ill prayed to Lord Shiva to heal him. In return, she would build a temple dedicating to the god and also fast until she saw its shikhara, that is, the temple's top. The queen's prayers were answered and the king invited the best architects in the land to carry out the task. But there was one problem. It would take months to execute the plans and that would mean the queen would starve before the temple was completed. Finally, an architect named Kokasa from Paithan came up with a plan. He suggested that the temple be carved from top to bottom, so they could start by sculpting the shikhara, and the queen, on seeing the top of the temple, could break her fast within a few days. Construction of the Kailasa Temple began in the 8th century. In the main courtyard is a monument of Nandi, facing the Shivalinga. At the base of the temple, there are carvings of elephants created to look as if the whole temple structure is being supported on the backs of these gigantic creatures. Two of the walls in the main temple house has carvings depicting the scenes from the two major Hindu epics, the Mahabharata along the north side and the Ramayana on the south side. In the southeastern part of the temple, there are 10 panels depicting the different avatars of Lord Vishnu. In the reign of Emperor Aurangzeb, orders were given to destroy the temple. 1,000 workers were sent to dismantle it. After all the attempts to harm the temple, it only suffered minimal damage. The workers could disfigure and break only a few statues. Aurangzeb finally gave up. Theorists believe that some higher power gave the technology to our ancestors to build the temple. Out of all the temples in Ellora, only Kailasa Temple is visible from the air if you fly over. It also shows X mark from the top, which is visible even in the aerial view of Kailasa Temple on Google Earth. The temple has a circular design with four lions on it. These four lions create this huge X mark. That is all for this episode. Hope you found this video useful. Like and share this video and also subscribe to Deepak's Creative World. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video.